So, this is the problem with making at-the-moment analysis videos. You might put up a video one afternoon, and the next morning wake up to more news about the subject you just covered. How is me doing a weekly podcast not enough to cover all of the Star Wars news? And he's Kylo Ren, he's just one freaking character. This is going to be a short add-on to my video about Ben Solo. As I said, the day after I posted that, we received some more news about our favorite patricidal superhuman warrior. That's an oddly specific superlative to have multiple characters in the running. While the actual comics haven't come out, some information about Ben Solo was revealed for the January solicits of Rise of Kylo Ren number 2. It's not much, but I'm addressing it because it actually contradicts a few things that I said in my previous video. The points I made were based on assumption, and now we're getting the real story. It's important because the new information reinforces my stance that Ben Solo will be redeemed. The Rise of Kylo Ren number 2 shows Ben Solo and Luke Skywalker fighting against the Knights of Ren. This is important because it means that Kylo didn't form the Knights of Ren. There was a wide assumption that the Knights of Ren were made up of Luke's former students who were willing to turn, while the ones who weren't were killed. Even more importantly, the teaser of the issue reveals that not only were the Knights of Ren not Luke's students, Ben didn't murder Luke's students. Well, okay, we don't actually know if he killed them or not, but there wasn't a temple massacre the night that Ben and Luke had their final confrontation, according to the teaser. With the new Jedi school in ruins and fellow students hot on his trail for the murder of their master, Ben Solo flees to the only friend he has left in the galaxy, a man named Snoke. But Snoke has plans for Ben, and ideas about the Force that are as dangerous as they are intriguing for the troubled young Jedi. This is a game changer. Rather than Kylo Ren being a disgruntled school shooter, as he's been termed by some of his detractors, his reasons for turning are shown in a much more sympathetic light. I'm going to set the scene. Ben Solo is a troubled young man. While he was still in the womb, his mother felt a dark presence trying to manipulate him, as revealed in the Aftermath trilogy. Whether this was Snoke or Palpatine or both, I don't know. As he grew up, his parents didn't know how to deal with him, so they sent him off to be trained with his uncle, albeit reluctantly on Han's part. Ben was completely ignorant to his relationship to Darth Vader, and finds out not from his family, but from a scandal erupting in his mother's political career, as revealed in the Bloodline book. Leia didn't even know where he was at the time, and so was unable to reach out to him to comfort him over the reveal. This more than likely put him even more off balance. Snoke by this point had reached out to him and was trying to gain his trust. Then he wakes up in the middle of the night to see his uncle standing over him, from Ben's perspective, ready to kill him. Ben defends himself. Then the only other people Ben has been around for the past few years, Luke's other students, turn on him and he has to run away. This is not an excuse for anything Kylo Ren has done in the movies. He's still done some terrible things that cannot just be forgotten about. But it does alter the perception of Ben Solo. While Snoke was trying to corrupt him, the true downfall of Ben Solo was being pushed away by those he cared about. He was cut off from his parents, he thought his uncle tried to murder him, and let's face it, Luke did consider it. The people who were closest to him drove him away, leaving him with only Snoke to turn to, a man who manipulated him for years. Snoke played on Ben's insecurities about abandonment, threatening to replace him with other apprentices, as shown in Snoke Age of Resistance, even essentially saying that Ben was his second choice and he would have preferred Luke. Ben Solo was set up to fall. He tells Rey to let the past die. That's because his past is filled with so much pain, he doesn't want to remember it. This is why I think Rey is so integral to his redemption. She is shown to have treated him with a humanity he hasn't felt in years. They are shown to have a deep connection to each other, a connection that he desperately needs and has been seeking in the wrong places, like his desire to please Snoke or begging Darth Vader's spirit to show him the true path. I don't have much more to add to this that wouldn't be retreading my previous video, but I do think I can make a prediction based on this recent revelation. I think Kylo Ren's redemption into Ben Solo won't lead to his death. The media that is coming out about Kylo Ren's fall is too focused on showing him sympathetically. No one will ever forget what he did. Perhaps Ben Solo will exile himself to the unknown region at the end, but I don't think the Lucasfilm Story Group would be taking such care to humanize him if it were just to prepare us for his death in The Rise of Skywalker. So tell me in the comments below if you think Ben Solo will survive The Rise of Skywalker. Next time, I promise to give you something non-Star Wars related, but a new episode of Trash Compactor is going up on Monday, and Sarah and I will be breaking down the final trailer. So like, comment, and subscribe to feed that beast of a YouTube algorithm. I'll see you next time.